True or false? Sadly, false. Sadly, fake news and rumors are always the runners. Fake news is not new at all, but the significant turning point in human civilization is about the 1990s, the rise of the internet, the heaven of anonymous. Before that, humans lied and mislead others as well. Early in the 13th century BC, Ramses the Great spread lies and propaganda, portraying the Battle of Kadesh as a stunning victory for the Egyptians. He depicted scenes of himself meeting his foes during the battle on the wall of nearly all his temples. The treaty between the Egyptians and the Hittites, however, reveals that the battle was actually a stalemate. After 1990s, on the internet, anyone can create such fake news or rumors very easily with anonymous identity at much faster speed. They can go viral very quickly at different platforms until we come up to kill them. But it seems that hardly it could be killed off. Why? Many scientists that have studied this phenomenon for years. There are two valuable reports have caught my eyes. One's from Stanford University, how fake news spread like a real virus. In 2019, by Professor Amy Elizabeth Peter Cornell's team, using the tools for modeling the spread of infectious diseases, several risk researchers at Stanford University at Stanford Engineering are analyzing the spread of fake news, much if it were the strain of Ebola or coronavirus. We want to find the most effective way to cut the transmission chance, correct the information, if possible, and educate the most vulnerable targets, said Elizabeth Pat Cornell. Their team have already broken down this topic into 5 sessions. How does fake news replicate across social media? What makes it spread faster? What kind of people are most susceptible? Is inoculation possible? What does the future hold? Here, let's focus on 2 important findings. 1. What kind of fake news spread most? By making comparison between trolls and bots, highly emotional messages with little information content can be either detected and blocked though, can spread rapid among people who already agree with this statement. 2. What kind of people are most susceptible? The considerable evidence shows that the elderly, the young, and the less educated people are more susceptible. Also, politicians at the political extremes, both liberal or conservative, because of confirmation bias, are easily susceptible. Another valuable scientific report is spread of true and false news online on the science. The MIT team verified a very famous quote from the American writer Mark Twain. A line can travel halfway around the world while the truth is putting on his shoes. Interrupted scientifically is lies spread faster than the truth. To understand how fake news spread, MIT team used a data set of rumor cascades on Twitter from 2006 to 2017. About 126,000 rumors were spread by 3 billion people. Fake news reached more people than the truth. The top 1% of fake news cascaded disputes to between 1,000 to 100,000 people, whereas the truth rarely disputes to more 100 people. Falsehood also diffused faster than the truth. The degree of novelty and the emotional reactions of recipients can be responsible for these differences observed. Falsehood disputes significantly further, faster, deeper, and more broadly than the truth in all categories of information. And the effects were more pronounced for fake political news than the fake news about terrorism, natural diseases, science, urban legends, or financial information. We found that fake news was more novel than true news, which suggested that people were more likely to share novel information. Whereas fake stories inspire fear, disgust, and surprise in replies, true stories inspired anticipation, sadness, joy, and trust. Contrary to the conventional wisdom, rumors accelerate the spread of true and fake news at the same speed.
Hello, humans!
In fact, the related modern studies, which were very similar to the fake news, can stem from 1940s. In 1947, published the book the psychology of rumor. Nowadays, something new updated when we wonder in what kind of situation the rumor or the fake news will spread. Based on the experiment on students, the researchers found that people spread rumors or fake news when they feel anxiety, when the information is important, when they believe the information, when it helps their self-image, when it helps their social status. Well, the most important thing is how should we stop the rumors or the fake news? Here is the vaccine for all lovers. Check whether yourself is the member of the susceptible groups or not. The elder, the young, and the less educated people. If you are, please try to shatter your information walls. Free yourself with open mind to hear different voices. You can try to make friends who are out of your conventional social circles, or you can learn how to admire your formidable enemies. 2. Emotional management. Fake news or the people who spread rumors get your attention by manipulating your emotions, especially the negative one, including fear, anger, anxiety, jealousy, and nationalism. If you don't want them got to you, it's very important to learn how to manage your emotions. Emotional maturity is the vital life lesson for all lovers. 3. Accepting new things with critical thinking. In this age of information explosion, when something new and important flawed, inviting critical thinking as your gatekeeper, which allows you to think about the logic of this news. This ability requires you to be knowledgeable by extensive reading and hard work learning logically. It's not easy to start, but once you shift these good habits, you will reap considerably in your whole life. Gradually, you will be able to detect and correct this information by asking relatively logical questions. Last but not least, don't disseminate fake news or rumors from you. As long as you detect or discern the fake news, kill them immediately. Besides the individuals, today, many big tech companies and the governments around the world have already taken actions to fight against the fake news and the rumors. For example, some tech giants have already hired AI technology to help the labor force to detect and kill the fake news, such as machine learning, comparative analysis, and a new algorithm Glover. Many governments in different countries also are taking actions, especially during this global pandemic, including law enforcement, media literacy, bill, internet shutdown, investigation, and so on. In 2020, many governments have already participated in this big campaign, such as Philippines and Vietnam, fight against the negative effects about the fake news spread on coronavirus. Fake news and truth are the two sides of the coin. As long as we are wise and persistent enough, for sure, we will kill off the fake news and live for the bright future to the truth. Hi everybody, I need your action. I need your action to detect and kill off the fake news or the rumors, to make a contribution to our more clear and more reliable information community. Please share my video to more people